Tell me if this has happened to you. You go searching through the Canva library and you find the perfect background for your design or social media post. You love the style. It's going to look great behind your text, but there's a problem. It's the wrong color. Well, by using Canva's editing tools, you can adjust the color of that background. You can even change it to match your brand colors. In this video, I'm going to show you three different ways that you can change the color of your background images so that you can stay on brand. My name is Kat, and this is Canva Catterday. When it comes to adjusting the photos in Canva, you have three main choices. One is to use filters, another is to use the photo adjustments, and then you can also use what's called Duotone. And we're going to go through all three of those methods. I have this image right here and click on Edit Photo. And we'll first look at filters. So click filters and then click see all. Here you have a variety of different filter options that will change that photo ever so slightly. This works best if you have an image that's close to your brand colors, but maybe not exactly like your brand colors, because you can adjust it by using some of these subtle filters. So you've got filters for natural, and you can see how it's got different color options. So if I were to click on something warm, it gives it a little more of an orange tone. If I want to go to something that's cool, it brings it down. It's a little more on the cooler tone, brings in some more blues. You can also make it a little more vivid if you want to and make it a little brighter, or you can even make it softer and a little more subtle. There's also an option for vintage, mono, which will bring it down to like a black and white, or even some additional options here called color pop, where you can change it completely by using one of those filters. And this is great for any photo that you just want to give it just a little bit of a different feel or a different vibe. It doesn't just have to be on a background image. You can apply these filters to any photo in Canva to give it a completely different look. So what if you want to make a more dramatic change to the color? For instance, I took that same background image and I took it from its original pink tones and I brought it down into the teal range. And we're going to work on that right now. So if you click on the photo and then click Edit Photo, this time we're going to go to the Adjust menu. So click on Adjust, and here are a whole bunch of new options. And I want to go through a couple of these. Temperature controls how warm or how cool that image is. So if I bring the temperature into the cooler range, it's going to add more blues. If I bring it higher, it's going to add more in the orange range. Tint is the balance between green and magenta in your image. So if I bring this down, you can see it's adding more green there. And this is adding those more magenta tones. I'm bringing it into the darker pinks right there. Then down here, you have vibrance and saturation. Saturation refers to the intensity of the color in the image. Higher saturation, the more intense the color. Lower the saturation or desaturate, and you've got a more subtle look. Vibrance is a type of saturation, but it's a little more of a subtle approach. It applies to the muted tones within your image, and it leaves the vibrant and the saturated colors alone. And then we have this relatively new option down here called Color Edit. And this one's really cool because this is going to help us completely change how this image looks. So first you want to click on this color box. It's going to show you the primary color that is in that image, and it's that pink tone. Let's click on that. And here we have a new set of options. You've got this hue button right here, and this refers to the actual color or shade of the image. And we can completely change it by using this hue slider. So let me do that and I'll show you what it does. I've got this button right here. I'm going to click it. And as I start to drag, watch how the color is going to change. So now it's coming into the more pinks, purples. Now we're going into the blue and into the greens. And then if I go the other way, it's going to go into the orange and the yellows and then bring me back to the greens and the blues. And this is how I was able to change that other image right here by using this color edit option. So I'm going to go down here right here. I've got my three brand colors. Well, these are a few of my brand colors, and I want to change this same image to match my brand colors. So to do that, you'll just take the slider until you get kind of close to what your image colors are. I recommend just taking a couple of your colors and adding them to the photo side by side so you can kind of compare them. So let's bring this slider down. I know that my colors are teal, so I have to go down towards this blue range. Actually, that's not too bad, but let me try the other way. That's a little better. We're getting a little closer to my color style right here. Now that I have it the way I want it, it's pretty close. I'm going to change the saturation just a little bit. I'm going to bring it up just a little bit. Whoops, I unclicked. There we go. Bring it up just a little bit. And then I want to bring the brightness down because it's a little too bright for me. And when I do that, look what it's doing. Now it's bringing it really close to my brand colors. If it's still not exactly right, I can also control the temperature up here and bring that down a little bit. Bring it a little more into the blue range. See, if I bring it this way, it goes blue. If I go this way, it goes more that yellow and orange. So I can bring that down just a little bit like this. That's pretty good. And I'm pretty darn close to my brand colors here just by using those adjustments and sliders. Let's go do a couple more. I have a few other photos down in here. Let's do this one. We're going to do this purple one right here. So I'm going to click on this image, click edit photo, go to adjust. Once again, here are your filters. You can see I've got filter options here. It will bring me in those shades, but because my colors are teal, there's really, and this one's kind of close, but it's not exact. It's a little too gray. There's really nothing here that's going to be exactly like my brand colors. So in this case, I won't use filters. I'll go to the adjustment setting. So click on adjust. I'm going to go right back down here to color edit and click on this purple color. And once again, I'm going to try to drag these sliders. I'll try it one way and then I'll go the other way. So let's go this way first. That's actually not bad. We're getting pretty close right there. Let me adjust the saturation a little bit. And I don't think I need to bring the brightness down. No, I'm going to leave the brightness alone, but I am going to change the temperature just a little bit. Bring it a little more to the green side. And that's pretty close. Not too bad. Let's go find this one. Let's grab this one right here. We've got this color right here. We're going to click edit photo, click on adjust. And again, click on that color edit and start to drag that slider. I love this one because this one's really dramatic. This one brings it into the purple. That's a gorgeous color. Purples, we've got those greens. This is a really pretty one to work with. All right, let's bring that kind of where I'm right about here, maybe. Yeah, right about there. And then I'm going to bring the brightness down just a little bit on this. And I'm going to desaturate this a little. I'm going to bring the saturation down so it's a little more subtle. There we go. Pretty good. You can also do this with background images, something like this. Maybe you have a product photo and you want to change the background. You can do that as well. Click on this. Click edit photo. Let's go see what we do with effects. We're going to click on these filters. These are nice. I can do something like this, where it brings it more into the orange range. I can bring it into the cool range. That's going to bring it more like a browner tone, or I can even make it a black and white if I want to, but I want to make it closer to my brand colors. So once again, back to the adjustments tab, go down here, click on the color option and start to drag that slider until it gets to be, what happened? I forgot to take the effect off my image. None. Had to go back to my original. Okay, let's try that again. Click on adjust, click on the color slider, and now we can drag that slider. Here we go. That's pretty good. That's pretty close. I think maybe I'll bring the brightness down just a little bit, and I'm going to desaturate it just a little bit as well. Pretty good, right? What about colors that are lighter? What about if you have something that's white? Well, you'll notice if you go to edit photo and go to adjust, you don't have that color option. Well, that's because it's white. So in this case, you have to do a couple other things. If it's something that's a really light background or a white background, I recommend going to the filters option first. So we're going to go to filters. I know that I want to bring this in the cooler range. So I'm going to go down here. This one is not bad. I'm going to click on that. We're getting there. I mean, at least I'm getting those tones in my color option right here. Once you've got that within the filter option, then you can go to the adjustments and I can change it a little bit more. I can change the saturation. I can bring the vibrance up or down, or I can even bring down the brightness a little bit. So let me bring the brightness down just a little. So I'm making it a little bit darker. And then I'm going to control the temperature and these other colors. So let's bring the vibrance up a little. Bring the saturation up a little. And let's change the temperature and the tint. So bring the tint down right about there. And the temperature right about, well, that's too much. That's too much blue. That's not bad. That's pretty good. But remember, we were working with a, and it's a little on the blue side. I probably should put a little more green in there, but we were working with a totally white image. But at least you can get it in that shade that matches your brand. Next, we're going to go to the other method, the third method, which is Duotone. So you're going to click on the photo, click edit photo, go down to effects, and over here you see Duotone right there. I'm going to click on that. Duotone takes the photo and it converts it into two colors only. Most photos have a lot more than two colors. What this will do is limit it to only those two colors. So I'm going to click any one of these. It doesn't really matter. It's giving you some suggestions here. So I'll just click this one right here. You've got these options for highlights and shadows. To make it your brand colors, you want to pick one of the lightest colors in your brand palette and then one of the darker colors in your brand palette. So you can see I have this light color right here and this dark color right here. I'm going to change it. I'm going to click on highlight. So let's copy this hex code number. There's that color number. And I'm going to change this photo. Go to Duotone. I'm going to click this first box that says highlights and change the number. And then I'm going to go to the second box and my second number is 006666. And there you have it. It just changed that to perfectly match my brand colors because I use the lighter and the darker of my brand. Let's go do that again. Let's grab this one. I'm going to go to edit photo, go to Duotone. And it, like I said, it doesn't matter which one of these you pick. For instance, if I were to pick this fuchsia color, I'm still going to change these to my brand color. So when it comes to Duotone, you can pick any one of these and then change it to match your brand. So once again, let's change that color. It was E6F2F2. And then for the darker shadow color was 006666. And I've just changed that image to match my brand. This same image looks a little different if you use Duotone versus if I use the photo adjustments. And that's what this is. This image right here, I use the Duotone method. This image right here, I use the photo adjustment method that we used previously. Let me go grab another page and I will show you. Actually, I'm going to just delete this one right here and I will bring this image back in. Let's bring this up. And let me show you how you change the photo colors and you'll see the difference. Back to adjust. You can see the primary color it's showing here is this blue and I needed that more teal color. So when I drag the slider, now it's bringing it more in that teal range for me versus the more subtle colors with the Duotone. So depending on the image itself, you might find that Duotone works better because it's going to give you that subtle look. But if you want a little more of a dramatic look, then you can use the photo adjustments. Now, this doesn't just work with single background images. You can do it with images something like this. You do want to be careful, though, because if there's a lot of color in the photo, you may have to do additional adjusting for each of the colors, but watch this. I've got this fun background right here and I want to change it. Click edit photo, click adjust, click this pink because it's telling me that pink is the primary color. Click on that and I'm going to adjust it. Let's go this way first. Look what it's doing on my background. It's completely changing the background so that that's pretty close to my brand color right there. It's a little on the light side. So I'm going to bring the saturation and the brightness. Oops, I unclicked. I'm going to bring the saturation and the brightness down. So let me bring down the brightness a little bit and let me just desaturate a little bit. Not bad. It's really close to my brand and it was originally pink. You can also do this with something that has maybe a solid color. I love this background right here, but blue is not one of my colors. I need to bring it more in this teal range. So again, you're going to click on the photo, click edit photo. Now here I have two colors. You see, it's giving me two color options because it's picking up this green of this plant. When you have an image that has multiple colors, you can adjust just one of them if you want to. So I want to change this blue, bring it a little more to the teal range. That's not bad, right about there. And then I'm going to bring the brightness down just a little bit and change the saturation a little bit. And there we go. I've just altered that color. This is so much fun when you want to go with all of those different backgrounds. You can see all of these different backgrounds are things that I've been playing with lately to see what type of effect I can get by using those different options. So go ahead and start playing with this. See if you like the filter option better or the duotone, or maybe going all in on the photo adjustments so you can get all of those background images to match your brand and have it any way you want it to be. I love using these options. They're really a lot of fun. I can't wait to see some of the different color combinations that you come up with. Be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my videos in the future. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.